Hey guys, welcome back to the Pine Box Perspective. And today I want to give you my perspective on what I think a minimalist EDC survival pack should look like. Before I do that, real quick, these shirts, guys, a couple of you were interested in them. I contacted the guy who's supposed to be making them for me. It's been like 5 or 6 weeks. I haven't heard anything back. So I called the guy and he's like, yeah, I haven't made those yet. So I'm supposed to call him back Monday. What I want to do is go ahead and order like 2 in every size. Kind of go from there. I'll give you an update on that. Okay, sorry about the wait on that. I hate to put something out there, not be able to have it available. I don't know if, you know, maybe the hurricane had something to do with it. Not really sure. But anyway, so 12 and a half ounces grenade pouch. This is pretty cool. My wife brought a few of these home the other day, well, actually a few weeks ago. And, you know, she's like, do you need these for anything? And I was like, I don't know, probably too small. Well, it dawned on me last night when I was sitting on the couch. I was like, hey, I can use that for something. So let's dump it out and see what we got in it. All right, guys. So I'm going to start off talking about the pouch itself, the little grenade pouch. I like this because it's got the good straps on it. Okay, the snap straps. They're on there pretty good. There's a strap behind this. So different configurations that you can do with this. It's got the Fastech buckle on the outside right here and the Velcro. Okay, now what I wanted to do with this pack basically was, I know what you're thinking, oh God, I see an Altoids can in there. Yeah, I know. But most of the time when people do those, they find like tiny little keychain flashlights, or, you know, your little Leatherman micros and just whatever super small things they could find. What I did was I take things out of my pack that I carry with me at work or EDC or whatever, and I wanted to compile a short list of things that I actually use, you know, that's big enough to actually hold in your hand, but small enough to fit into a small package. Okay, so the Altoids tin kind of helped tie it all together. Starting off, I just kind of hung, I think this is roughly 25 feet of paracord. I know a lot of you guys like your bank line and things like that. I've got a ton of paracord, and I haven't bought any bank line yet because I've got, my great-grandfather had a ton of braided fishing line, like really thick stuff that I use for different things like that. But most of the time, this is the most practical thing for me and what I do. So, 25 feet, you got plenty of cordage there to do a lot of things with. So now, bandana, if I can get it out, just kind of fold it up into a little cube there, fits right in front of it, keeps everything nice and snug. And then you got your Altoids tin. So that's pretty much it for the pouch. There is on the inside of this pouch on both sides, I don't think you can see it, it's pretty dark in there. There's like a little I'm going to say 1 to 2 inch strip of molly webbing on each side. You could utilize that if you want to. I chose not to because the sides are kind of open on this. So if it were to get turned upside down, say if you had a flashlight in there, it might slip out. So that's why I tried to fit everything inside of this. Okay. But this is a neat little way to carry something. You can attach it with this size. You could put it on a shoulder strap on a bag. I like it for my belt. I think it's pretty neat. So, and you could take several of these and outfit them differently. You know, you could have one with a small minimalist shelter system in it. Anyway, you can do things like that and not have to carry a full pack with you all the time. If you're just playing around in the woods, going on a day hike, something like that. Sometimes you get, you know, kind of tired of having weight on your shoulders. You know, I get that. So anyway, this is a lot of these, you get them and they're kind of really thin and flimsy. This is a pretty good, tough sort of a canvas material here. This one seems to be really well made. It's got a drain port in the bottom too. My Yaesu FT4XR, my ham radio, will fit in this with the antenna sticking out on the side. So really like that. This thing's very well put together. Really like these snap straps here. You could feed them through here and have a smaller belt loop on the top or bottom if you want to position it, you know, up or down just a little bit more. So these things, I think, you know, they're like $10 or less at your local military surplus place. Find them online all day long. So pretty neat little piece of equipment now that I think about it. Okay, Ranger bands, everybody's got them, everybody knows what they are. On my Altoids tin, I covered it on the inside and outside with strips of duct tape, and what I did was I took the duct tape and I ran a solid strip, and there was a little bit left here. So I made some thinner strips and put on there. You can see the line. And I did the same thing around the side. The sides, there'll be a shorter one here in the middle where it didn't meet all the way across. Okay, and the same thing on the back. For different sizes, different binding applications, okay? Maybe you run out of Band-Aids, you wanna wrap that around your finger. I did that the other day at work, cut myself, shocked myself all the time. You know, but a little piece of tape stops you from bleeding all over the place. And, you know, this is cool digital duct tape I got from Walmart a few years ago, so can't argue with that. Now, like I said, what I wanted to do with this is use things that I use every day. The other thing that I wanted to do with this is I wanted to pack it so that if you've got, like, you could probably fit 50 different little tiny items in here, but then you're going to be fumbling around with how you package it, and it's like you ordered something from China and you want to return it and you can't get it back in the box. You're not going to want to mess with that. I wanted this to be usable to me, okay? So, you know, I've got tender tabs. I've got 6 of them here in a little Ziploc, small Ziploc bag that's folded over, and that fits right over top of the flashlight and the small ferro rod. The knife takes up a good bit of room in this tin, but it's a good usable knife. This is the one that I used on my 1 pound survival pack. It's got the saw in it and, you know, every other thing else. It's hard to do this backwards. I'm going to start here. A spare battery for my flashlight. You know, these AAAs in these little Streamlight Micros. This is honestly my favorite flashlight. I use it all the time. Okay, so I like to have at least one spare battery for that. It does last a really good long time. I've mentioned this in several of my videos. This one has the reversible clip on it, so you can put it on a hat. And I'll show you real quick. Let me get my hat. So, obviously, I like to have a headlamp. Don't always have room for a headlamp when you're dealing with these smaller packs. So, just clip this thing on the bill of your hat. If I don't tear my hat up, it's getting pretty old. And I've actually done this at work. You've got a headlamp or you've got a handheld, whatever you want. Guys, for, what is it, 20 bucks? These are really phenomenal flashlights. Really like them. So I've got extra fuel for that. Oh yeah, I've got another piece of duct tape on the inside. I think I mentioned that. This is the Victorinox Hiker. Like I said, it's got the saw in it, the 2 blades. Yeah, your standard stuff does not have the scissors, but it's got the, I like this one because it's got the 3D Phillips head screwdriver on it. And then you've got, on the other tools, you've got your flat heads, a couple of different sizes. So, good little knife to have. Now, yeah, you can get smaller ones of these. I've got one of the little classics, but, you know, again, like I said, I want something to be big enough to actually really want to use. And I have tried carrying that little tiny knife before, and it's got scissors in it, which is nice, but really the only thing I ever did with it was trim my mustache and pick my teeth and things. So, good size knife to use. You can do a lot with this, and it's got the saw. And this is my favorite small ferro rod here, the Exotac Nano XL. Now, I like this one because it's completely self-contained. Typically, I just like an open one, but for an Altoids 10, this is good because, you know, it's got the striker built into it, and when it comes apart and you put it back together with the handle on it, now you've got something big enough to work with, you know, that wouldn't really fit in here. It might, no, it won't go in there sideways. And you've got the striker already built in. So, you know, you can see that's plenty big enough to work with. Typically, I'll tie a string around that little loop in the striker just to give my fingers a little something to hang on to there, because this is kind of, you can only get a finger and a thumb on this to strike it, and it can be a little bit difficult at times, but, you know, tie a little piece of string on there. I had a keychain thing on here, and it wouldn't fit in the can, so I just took it off for this video. I'll put this back together before I lose it. This stump is hollow. Big hole in the bottom. All right, now got a couple of Band-Aids down here, so this will be my super minimalist first aid. You know, just 2 good fabric Band-Aids that won't come off when they're wet a little bit. I've got 6 of the 500 milligram extra strength Tylenol. I get migraines sometimes, but they're, you know, good for a lot of things, fevers and stuff like that, pain. This is about all they want you to take, the recommended dosage in 24 hours, you know, so every 6 hours. So this ought to go a long way. And then I've got some Aqua Tabs in here. I was able to fit 4 of these little strips in here, so I've got 8. Okay, so that's 8 liters of water that I could treat if it's really nasty. Now, a lot of people will carry signaling mirrors and different things, Fresnel lenses and all that stuff, your wallet cards, they'll put some of those in here too. Honestly, if you take a little bit of buffing compound and a paper towel or a bandana or something and kind of polish the bottom of that, you get a pretty good little shine out of that. I mean, it's not perfect. It's not the best thing in the world, but it does work. I was playing around with it, you know, in theory, just to see how that would go. So, all right, guys, we've got roughly 12 items here, okay, coming in at 12 and a half ounces. Depending on how much cordage you got, you could, you know, get smaller than that. So this is a good little thing I think you could have. You could attach it to you. You could leave it in the car if you don't want to carry all the stuff in your pockets. I hate having stuff in my pockets all the time. That's why I do like to carry some kind of a pack usually. But this is pretty neat. I could come out here and play in the woods with this thing. I could take it hunting with me. I could go on a day hike, and if a disaster struck somehow, I'd have a few things to kind of get me going, you know? So that's pretty much all there is to it. You know, ranger bands, things like this, they've got multiple uses, you know, for binding and keeping everything together and stuff like that. One thing that, if you could find a small little canister of hand sanitizer, obviously you can sanitize your hands with it and keep things clean, but, you know, also really awesome fire starter. One of my favorites, actually. If you get one that doesn't leak and you can fit it down in here. Like I said, I think people get too crazy with these things, and they have fun, and it's cool. You know, they have fun trying to see how many items they can get in these little Altoids tins. To me, it's not necessarily that practical. Like the little tiny ferro rods you get, yeah, they work, but I mean, it kind of sucks. I mean, I'd like to have something that I'm much more comfortable using, something that I've used before, you know, several times. So anyway, guys, let me know what you think. Kind of a short video here, shorter than what I typically do, but like I said, it's just short and sweet, not a whole lot to it. So, all right, guys, thanks. Take care. Before you take care, wouldn't you know, I'd forget to mention something. If you want to go with the tiny gear route, one thing you can do with these little pouches here, go to the Dollar Tree, and for $1.25, you get 4 of these cans that are a little bit bigger than a dip can, I believe, and they'll fit down in here if you want to go do something else. And it fits down in there actually a good bit further, and you know, the shape of the pouch actually contours that a little bit better. That's one option, one cheap option. And if you want to double down on that, looking for multiple uses of things, drill yourself a 1/4-inch hole in this thing, and you can use it to make char cloth or char, get yourself some punk wood. All you gotta do is put it in there, throw it in a fire. You know, the hole in it will actually, when the gases are escaping, it'll catch on fire, and when it goes out, take it out of the fire, let it cool off, and you got some char. So you could actually put you know, a piece of flint and your striker in here and have a nice little flint and steel kind of a pouch if you just want to use it for something like that. So multiple uses with these things, really like them. One more thing, of course, I had to bring my spanker out here because you have no water with this thing. You got a way to treat water, but not really a good way to carry water. You can outfit this to the front of this, and you've got a nice little skeletonized all around canister, cup, survival pack, I guess if you want to call it that. You know, something to kind of make the day a little bit easier. One more idea that I had that I forgot to mention. You can get these Ziploc bags, you know, you can get them a little bit thicker, a little bit tougher, and you could put it on the outside of this if you wanted to, all right? And that'll help keep everything dry, which I'm not really necessarily worried about it unless it's in a pour down. But you could take that bag, if you got the thicker ones, and you could open it up, and you've got maybe an 8-ounce cup, so you could catch some rainwater or get some water from somewhere and drink out of that bag if you wanted to, okay? All right, that's it. I promise this time. Guys, thanks for watching. Take care. We'll see you next time.